We all know by now that there are a lot of creeps on the internet, but there are some spaces that you would never suspect them to be. Y'all, the creeps are making their way to every corner of the online world, even video editing apps. There's this one app which basically tried to be the new TikTok, and loads of kids were using it to post videos and challenges. However, it started to take a turn for the worse. Soon enough, this app became a place for creepy adults and groomers to prey on young, innocent children and teenagers. And nobody did anything about it. So you guys, the app I'm talking about today is called Funimate. And on the App Store, it's described as a video editing app. People use it to edit their videos for TikToks, to make them look more impressive and grow their following, or just to mess around with the video effects. However, loves, it's not just an editing app. Funimate users can share their videos directly on the app and interact with other users. One of the reasons people like to share their videos on the app is to participate in its weekly challenges, which is a feature that is advertised on the App Store. This is a really popular app. It has over 10 million downloads and over 1 million reviewers, with an average rating of 4.3 out of 5. So people seem to really like it. Funimate also has a YouTube channel where they post tutorials, and you can definitely tell from the thumbnails and the way the app is marketed that it's for younger people. So on the App Store, it's rated as parental guidance recommended, but users can interact with each other and there are in-app purchases. But a lot of people don't know that there are other things on this app that are not suitable for children at all, which the app gives literally no warning for. Plus, you guys, it's super easy to create an account. You can literally put in any fake email address and sign up without even verifying it, and just use the app freely. Anyone can get on this app and be pretty much totally anonymous. Unfortunately though, due to some of these weekly challenges and the young users on the app, predators started using Funimate to talk with underage children. And it shed a light on the kind of inappropriate and illegal content that Funimate is willing to have on their platform. So y'all, this app came under fire after one of their challenges got out of hand. The Freaky Challenge, where people had to post the freakiest thing they could think of. And with the internet being the internet, this challenge went dirty. Some of the videos posted as a part of the challenge were of people doing explicit acts and things that would definitely be rated 18 plus, not just parental guidance. And bear in mind, most of the people using this app are children. Having this content online is so illegal and so disturbing. A lot of kids on the app were also putting their ages in their bios, saying they were single and asking to chat with people, which is usually totally innocent, but in this case, it was just fuel for these dangerous predators. The Freaky Challenge isn't even the first time this app has been caught allowing inappropriate content either. There was another challenge called the Foreigner Challenge, where people would show themselves normally, and then when the beat would drop, they would show themselves without any clothes on. And some of the people doing this challenge were children. And like I said, it's really easy to make an account on Funimate, so there were some people on the app who were there with bad intentions. Grown adults were liking these explicit videos and trying to chat with these kids. But y'all, even though all this creepy stuff was going on, Funimate seemed to just ignore it completely. They kept the videos up, and a lot of predators and groomers were using the app and these challenges to look at inappropriate videos of children. The weird thing is, even though a lot of predators who are interested in people way younger than them can be hidden in weird corners of the internet, there have been a couple of recent cases of child grooming and inappropriate relationships with underage people from popular influencers and TikTokers, for example, Zoe Laverne and Jerobe. I have spoken about the Jerobe situation in a little bit more detail in another video, but the gist is that Jerobe was a popular creator on TikTok who was 26 at the time of this scandal, and he used his large audience of over 4 million followers, as well as his age, to manipulate and groom younger TikTokers. He ended up worming his way into a group chat with kids as young as 13 years old, getting them to call him hot and saying inappropriate things to them. He even tried to get them to come and stay in an Airbnb with him, and offered to buy them alcohol if they want. He used to make loads of videos calling other people out for doing creepy and messed up things, which was the perfect cover to make the kids he was talking to think that there was nothing weird going on. Another case of an influencer having inappropriate relationship with a child was Zoe Laverne. Do y'all remember when it came out that she kissed Connor, that 13-year-old, when she was 19? She claimed that she wasn't grooming him and that they were just friends and happened to catch feelings for each other. Even if she wasn't intending to groom him, having a relationship with and kissing a 13-year-old when you are 19 is so weird. Why on earth would she even be attracted to him in the first place? He is a literal child. She had nearly 18 million followers on TikTok at the time. And so when you add how much older she was to him to the equation, there was definitely a power imbalance there. Zoe didn't even seem to have suffered that much from this either. Her TikTok is still huge. She now has almost 21 million followers, so she's actually more famous than she was before. Everyone just seems to have forgotten what she did. I feel so bad for the people in these situations. Having to go through something like that at such a young age must be really difficult, especially when it's broadcast online and everyone wants to give their opinions on it. Connor seemed pretty shaken up about everything too. He went on live and said it's really hard for him to deal with because he's only 13. But you guys, back to the topic of Funimate. The sad thing is, there are actually a lot of really talented creators on there, and it looks like a useful app if you like video editing and making TikToks or fan edits. But the creeps who go on it are just kind of ruining it for everyone else. If you do use the app, make sure to check your privacy settings so that people who you don't know can't message you or see your page. It's so important to stay safe online, loves. Underage kids should not be able to post inappropriate content like they have been on Funimate. And Funimate needs to take more responsibility to make their app a safer place for children. The fact that you can go on there, create an account with a fake email address that doesn't have to be verified, and scroll freely through people's videos is concerning, especially since Funimate have allowed inappropriate content involving minors on their platform. This app needs to do something to keep its users safe, whether that's bringing up the age rating so that younger children can't use the app, being more aware of inappropriate or illegal content, or making sure that accounts need to be verified so that they're less anonymous. Anyways, y'all, I'm not saying never use this app again, because like I said, there are a lot of talented creators on Funimate who enjoy using it, and it looks like a pretty good video editing app. However, just be careful about what you post on there and the people who follow you. If you guys see anything shady or illegal, make sure to report it straight away so it can be taken down. Well, loves, what do you think about this situation? What can Funimate do to stop this grooming and predator problem? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I love you so much!